evening celebrity challenge, former WBA featherweight boxing champion of the world, Barry McGuigan. Great Britain international rugby hero, Martin Offiah. Former British captain and now international rugby coach, the great Ellery Hanley. 400-metre Olympic athlete and gladiator timekeeper Derek Redmond, Britain's world champion stunt riding superstar Eddie Kidd, and Aston Villa international goalkeeping hero Mark Bosnich. Tonight, face the challenge of the Gladiators. Now welcome your hosts, John Fashanu and Ulrika Johnson.
And to a very special edition of Gladiators. It's special because tonight's six contenders are all celebrity sportsmen in their own right. Now, we've got a fabulous show ahead of us, and it's in fact for charity, isn't it, Fash?
That's right, a very, very good charity. I mean, some of the boys that we've got backstage are some of the biggest names in the country, so they're all here on a very, very worthy cause.
Well, before we let the proceedings carry on, of course, I'm going to introduce you to a very special man indeed, a gentleman who's come all the way over from America to help Fash Out present the international shows we'll be showing you next year, while I, of course, take a well-earned rest. He's the presenter of American Gladiators. Please give a very warm British welcome to Mike Adamley. That's nice.
Birmingham, England is wonderful. What else can I say?
Now, as well as presenting American Gladiators for 6 years, you used to play American football, didn't you?
I played American football for 7 years for the New York Jets and the Chicago Bears, if people know those teams.
Yes, American football is very big in England now. And you're going to be doing the international shows. Are you looking forward to that?
Very much so. I think the International Gladiators is sort of the wave of the future. It's seen in 40 countries around the world now. The Finns and now the Russians are going to start their own versions of it. So the sky's the limit, and it will be great. It'll be sort of like a United Nations of gladiators.
I think it should become an Olympic discipline, don't you?
Yes,
absolutely. That's great. Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Adamley. So let's meet our celebrity contenders. Tonight they are Eddie Kidd,
Barry McGuigan,
and Ellery Hanley.
Eddie, very warm welcome. You're our world champion motorcycle jumper. I gather you've just won the world championship.
That's correct. I just beat Evel Knievel's son in the States. The world championship jumped over 40 cars. I beat him by 6 foot and I brought the belt back to England.
Hey! Now, there is some money at stake here and you're going to be giving it to charity. Which charity would your money be going to?
Well, I do a lot of work for Save the Children and also leukemia research, so I'll be splitting the money if I win.
Well, the very best of luck tonight. Let's hear it for Eddie Kidd.
Barry, former world WBA featherweight champion, quick hands, fast feet, tough guy. Are those kind of attributes going to help you against the likes of Wolf and Saracen and Shadow here?
Short answer, no. if I were 30 pounds heavier, 2.5 stone heavier, and a little bit more height, I might have a better chance. But I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be great fun.
You're great at dealing with pressure, but your wife, Sandra, and your four children are sitting over there. That is real pressure. I imagine if you don't do well here at the National Indoor Arena, there is going to be heck to pay.
I'm going to get a hammering when I go home, you know. I already do. Those three boys over there are tough to handle, so I can imagine these big men are going to be even tougher. And looking forward to the competition. Saracen and Wolf and them all are very, very strong. But we're going to have good fun.
Barry McGuigan, best of luck.
Thanks very much.
Now, Ellery, tell us a little bit. You've got rugby union and rugby league. Which one is it you play for?
I play for the one what pays, rugby league.
Oh, that's the one that pays the money. Now, you've seen the events. You went through them earlier on the dummy run. Are there any of the events you're really worried about?
Yeah, just about all of them. I'm scared to death of the gladiators. But now I'm looking forward to it, and I'm hoping that I'm going to put up a good show and everything, but these guys are something else, and girls too.
Ellery, get yourself ready. We wish you all the best. Over you go. Ellery Hanley!
And we have three more celebrity contenders. They are Martin Offiah,
Mark Bosnich,
and Derek Redmond.
Hi, Martin. Standing next to one of the biggest names in rugby league, what's it feel like to be on Gladiators?
Well, it's quite nerve-wracking. You know, it was very tiring as well, especially in the warm-ups.
Well, how did you find the warm-ups? It's quite different from all the things you do.
Yeah, it's obviously I've seen it on TV, and thrilled to have the chance and see it firsthand. But I'm sure it's going to be very tiring.
Well, I hope you don't get bruised tonight. As I was saying before, there is a lot of money to be won tonight. Have you got any special charity at all that you might be donating the money to?
Well, I don't think my charities better hold their breath, but if I do manage to win, I think anything to do with helping to provide good care for children.
Oh, that's lovely. Let's hear it for Martin Offiah. Good luck.
Mark, your dashing exploits as a goalkeeper are well known, but can those attributes like quickness and agility and reaction time work for you here on celebrity Gladiators?
I don't really know, hopefully. Looking at the Gladiators, I don't think it'll be much chance, but I'll do my best anyway.
You are a superstar in your sport. Is it difficult for you to come in here knowing that somebody might make some fun of you?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's all for a good charity in that, but everyone knows that to professionals, any type of competition, there's a little bit of pride involved, so we'll all want to do our best and not be showing up.
Okay, Mark, best of luck. Mark Bosnich.
Now, Derek, you recently got married, of course, to Sharon. You've got a little child. How are they? Are they well?
Yeah, they're both very well, and they're actually sitting here watching, so I've got to put on a good show for them today.
Of course. Now, how seriously are you taking it today, and how do you think you're going to do?
Well, I'll answer it the other way around. I hope I do well. I think we're all taking it seriously. It's very hard to bring 8 world-class athletes or sportsmen in their own right and just tell them, you know, have some fun out there. So there is quite a high competitive edge out there. But we are here to have a bit of fun. It is for charity. We do want to enjoy ourselves. But, you know, when we're out here in the arena, I think the contenders and also the gladiators will take it, you know, seriously and play hard and fair.
They certainly will. Thanks very much. Derek Redmond, off you go.
So some tough celebrity contenders there for our gladiators tonight. Now, tonight is, of course, all about charity, and every single person here in the audience has made a donation of £5 towards charity, in fact, towards the Variety Club of Great Britain. That has enabled us to buy a Gladiators Sunshine Coach, which we're going to donate to the Leyland School for Children with Special Needs. Generosity. Mike.
You've seen the gladiators, you've heard from our celebrities. Let the games begin. Event number one, Atlaspheres.
So our contenders are ready. And in the blue Atlasphere is Ellery Hanley. And in the yellow is Barry McGuigan. And in the orange sphere, the awesome Shadow and Trojan. Oh, look at John Anderson.
Celebrities ready.
Gladiators Shadow and Trojan get rolling to test the Big Bang Theory. Already Ellery Hanley among the points on court number 3. Trojan arriving too late for the ball. Former boxer Barry McGuigan picks up 3 on pod 4, looking for a points victory this evening. Trojan marking out Ellery. Here comes Barry again. Another 3 points on pod number 3. Trojan and Shadow ignoring our boxer at the moment to their cost. Ellery on pod 1, and he can't convert it. Go on, Ellery. Heave. Well, coming from rugby, he's used to a ball of a different shape. Oh, Barry's knocked him onto the pod. Now he can't get off. traffic jam on pod two. Here comes Ellery. Again on pod four. Scores! Trojan once again turns up late for the party. Celebrities were hot stuff in those atmospheres. In the replay, we can see Ellery still smoking. Hope he likes kippers.
Shadow, what's it like? Teamwork involved?
Yeah, there's a lot of teamwork involved. We've never played against three players before. It was a very interesting game. We figured we'd let Barry run around and do his thing, and we'd try and block out the other two. That's about it, really.
Well done. Let's hear it for our Gladiators, Trojan and the awesome Shadow.
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Oh, yeah. And a Merry Christmas to you guys, but here's an unwelcome present this festive season. Climbing into his metal gift wrapping is Wolf. Wouldn't like that in my stocking.
And in the yellow sphere, Martin Offiah. And in the blue, Derek Redmond. And in the orange, Mark Bosnich. And they're going to be chased by the Hunter. And the man we love to hate, the Wolfman.
Celebrities ready! Gladiators ready! 3, 2, 1!
Hunter and the Wolfman about to do the Gladiator rock and roll on our three celebrity contenders.
That's right, Mike, and oh, Mark Bosnich scores a goal, and Martin Offiah fires off the smoke for 3 points as well. Goalkeeper Mark Bosnich really knows how to handle these giant footballs. Scores again. Here's Martin, slammed into the points by Wolfman. Derek Redmond sprints across pod three, just fails to smoke it.
Very difficult here for the Gladiators to play 2-on-3. Mark Bosnich scores again.
It is difficult, Mike, and that's why Martin's building up such a great score. And Mark Bosnich has found some space coming up. Picks up 3 points on two. And just like Jim Carrey in The Mask, he's smoking. And Derek Redmond, he's off and running.
Derek settles into scoring pod number four just before time expires. The contenders looking good in Atlaspheres.
They certainly are, Mike. And as you said, difficult for two Gladiators to keep track of three contenders. The goalkeeper, Bosnich, enjoying being a striker for a change.
Quite frankly, where were you, Wolfman?
Oh, come on.
I rushed to the middle with the greatest speed possible, and who do I meet? Hunter. Oh, that was a gun. I was so scared.
You've only been doing this 359 million times. Let's hear it for Hunter and Wolfman.
I hate this music. I don't like it. I'm not impressed.
But I'm impressed with Mark Bosnich. After one event, he's top of the celebrity Christmas tree with 12 points. Ellery has 9, Martin 9, Barry 6, Derek 3, and Eddie yet to get off the mark.
So now it's time for event number 2, which is pyramid and raring to go. It's Eddie, Barry, and Ellery, and tonight they're facing Hunter, Shadow, and the Wolfman.
Instead of 2-on-2, it's 3-on-3.
Yes, Mike, it's going to be tough for Gladiators and contenders. It's Hunter on rugby coach Ellery Hanley. And Shadow on Eddie Kidd. Now, he should be used to being a full guy.
Barry McGuigan is getting worked over by the Wolfman, who's playing around a little bit up there on the pyramid.
Wolf's used to playing around everywhere, actually.
All three of our celebs having a dickens of a time. Down goes Shadow, down goes Eddie Kidd.
What a downer.
Barry McGuigan trying to get away from the Wolfman. I think the Wolfman... Wolf just teasing him. And look at this. Eddie Kidd has broken loose from
he
Shadow.
He crossed him. Look at
hey,
that.
He's got 10 points.
Oh, that was beautiful.
Looked great there. Still some time on the clock. Time for Ellery and Barry to score.
Not if Ellery keeps hitting the bottom like
if
that.
If Barry can get away from the Wolfman, he's got 5.
This looks bad. Oh, he's got a ball. Was cheeky. Well, I know it's Christmas Eve, but it's a little early to be looking at his presents. Time up, thank goodness. The Wolf should be pulling crackers at Christmas, not Barry McGuigan's shorts down. Oh, yes, I thought we'd get a replay. One of those magic moments that only happen on Gladiators.
Well, Barry, what a fine moment. I've been doing this show for 3 years, and it's the first time I've blushed. For the ladies and gentlemen on this side,
you missed it.
You missed it. Barry's bottom.
Yeah, well, thanks to the Wolf for putting my trousers down.
I don't think that's allowed, do you?
No, I should be given 10 points for that. He made me show my bottom. For those of you on this side, you had a good time, yeah?
Well, certainly, Eddie, you had a good time because you made it to the top. Some great falls off there, some real stunt falls. But you managed to pick up 10 points.
Yeah, I'm well happy about that. When Shadow threw me, I didn't think I was going to hit the deck. Threw me so hard, I thought I was going to clear the red carpet.
Well, you did very well indeed. Ellery, you didn't quite make it to the top, but I know you enjoyed this one, didn't you?
Absolutely. I like the falling and rolling and tumbling. It was absolutely magnificent. Them guys are absolutely fit. And I tell you what, you've got to actually try it to believe how hard it is.
Let's hear it for Ellery, Eddie and Barry. It's Martin, Derek and Mark, and they face a fresh batch of gladiators. They are Trojan, Saracen and Cobra. Over to John Anderson.
Celebrities ready! Gladiators ready! 3, 2,
well, let's see whose sport serves them the best, rugby, track or football.
All three men on the same side of the pyramid, and that is makes it a little bit easier for our three gladiators, Trojan, Saracen and Cobra.
It's Martin Offiah doing the bunny hop.
Uh-oh, breakaway here.
It's Derek Redmond sprinting to the top.
He's got 10 points.
Good to see the fireworks flashing and not Wolf. Derek showing the form that made him so successful in the 400 metres. Cobra hits the bottom as Mark Bosnich hits the top.
He's got 5.
Yes, 5 points for being second to the top, and Martin can pick up 2 points if he can make it up there too.
Well, some way, with 15 seconds left in the clock, Martin will try to figure a way to get past Trojan. If he can do that, he'll get 2, but that does not look like it's going to be the case.
Yes, Mike, it looks like the bunny's won out of bounds.
3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second, and that is it.
There's the whistle.
So Derek Redmond gets 10. Mark Bosnich, 5 in pyramid.
Martin not scoring, but he's got 3 events ahead of him. In the replay, we can see how Derek put those sprinter's legs to good effect. I've not seen anyone leave Saracen looking like he's in slow motion before. Look at the speed of him.
Well, Derek, this begs the question. Have you got an unfair advantage? Have you watched this enough time to know that there's a technique to get up there?
Yeah, the only reason I'm doing this show is so I haven't got one of them black and white striped outfits.
Well, you look very good tonight. You picked up 10 points. You must be pleased with that.
Oh, yeah, well happy I'm alive at the moment.
And what about you, Mark? Did you enjoy that one?
Yeah, very hard, very difficult.
Well, you picked up 5 points, which isn't too bad because you were second one up there, but looked a little bit tentative to start with.
Yeah, I was just sort of testing him out at the start, but he's trying to tickle me. But after I got over that spell, I was okay.
Well, it sounds to me like there's a little bit of cheating going on the gladiators' behalf. Now, there was a lot of jumping around, yeah. Not a lot of jumping up, Martin.
No.
I mean, what was this two at a time bit? Yeah. I mean...
That was my secret weapon.
Well.
It backfired. He was too strong.
It certainly did, but you look as if you all enjoyed it. Go and get yourselves a glass of water. Mark, Derek and Martin!
Well, it's usually the gladiators with all the bunny, but here's Martin trying it on, and he's yanked back, one-legged. I don't think this technique will catch on.
Scores after two events. Mark maintains his lead with 17. Derek's on 13. Eddie moves off the bottom into third with 10. Our rugby men, Ellery and Martin, are on 9. And Barry's at the bottom with 6.
So it's 2 down, 3 to go. More action here after the break on Celebrity Gladiators. Indoor arena and to part two, where we're just about to kick off with event number 3, which is the wall. And standing at the foot of the wall is Barry. He's going to be chased by Falcon. Also contemplating the 36 feet ahead of him, it's Eddie, and he's going to be chased by Scorpio. Over to John Anderson.
Celebrities, you will go on my first whistle. Gladiators, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
And in this celebrity wall, our two celebs, Barry and Eddie, will be getting a 10-second head start on our gladiators.
Well, I don't know what Barry thinks he's doing. Looks like he's taking a bow. He should be going up. Here come the gladiators.
Barry, the low man in the totem pole at the moment right now. In danger of being eliminated. Look at Eddie Kidd, though.
Doing well.
Getting very close to the summit.
Yes, he is, and Barry stepped up a gear, too.
Eddie Kidd up and over. He's got 10 more points.
Barry's over, eventually, for 5 points. And don't his kids look happy about it?
Eddie, how did you find that? Made it look easy.
It's frightening, especially when you've got a woman chasing you.
I think you're used to that, aren't you? That doesn't worry you.
Well, it does sometimes.
Well, well done, Eddie, you got yourself 10 points.
Thank you very much.
Barry, how did you find that? Did well?
Well, I actually slowed down and hoping that you would catch me. in actual fact, it was good fun. I missed my place and just after it started, and I found it hard to get back, but yeah, I got up there, lovely.
Well done, Barry, 5 points.
To know fire eyeing up the wall, we asked him what he thought rugby and gladiators had in common.
In my sport, I spend a lot of time running away from fellows who are quite a lot larger than myself.
Martin's going to be chased by Nightshade. Ellery's going to be chased by Lightning. John Anderson.
Celebrities, you will go on my first whistle. Gladiators, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1. Well, it's the battle of the rugby stars, Martin and Ellery, and Martin said he normally finds himself running away from the big fellas. Now he's running away from the big girls, and they don't get much bigger than Nightshade.
Here comes Lightning and Nightshade, two super climbers, and Ellery is in trouble right away. Lightning hot on his trail. She's got his right leg.
And she's not going to let him go now, Mike. Martin's doing well, and he needs the points, pulling away from Nightshade.
Martin has made it to the top, however. He's got 10 points. He's moving on in the competition for sure.
Ellery has got Lightning on his back. Who changed places with him? I think we all would, actually.
This is great.
It certainly is, Mike.
Lightning is having the ride of her life. Ellery's not going anywhere, at least he doesn't want to.
Certainly beats tackling in rugby. Oh, she's off. She's taking him off. She's pulled.
Ellery Hanley comes off the wall. It wasn't easy for Lightning, however.
Martin, what were you just saying then?
I was so scared. It reminded me of my sister chasing me when I was little.
No wonder you got there so quickly.
Yeah, well, it wasn't the best technique, but you know, luckily I got up there.
You were a bit worried about that, weren't you?
Oh, yeah, I know.
Well, you got yourself 10 points. Well done.
Thanks so much.
Nightshade, how fast was he?
Well, he was very fast. I'm not surprised he's one of the most valuable players in Britain today.
Do you think if you'd have caught him, you'd have been able to pull him off that wall?
Well, I would have had a good try, but it'd been rather nice cuddling him for a while.
Well, there you are. Let's hear it for Nightshade.
Ellery.
Oh, boy.
You must have been tackled before, but not by a gladiator, and not for that long, and not with so much enjoyment.
Well, it was absolutely fantastic. The thing about it was... the thing about it was that I'd planned it all morning, thinking, right, I've got my route ready and everything, and then I set off, hell for leather, got my foot grips going and everything,
And then all of a sudden I could smell all this perfume coming after me. So I gave in.
You did enjoy it then?
Fantastic, absolutely brilliant.
I mean, me has a tough grip, doesn't he?
He certainly does. I couldn't have tried any harder there. I mean, you saw what happened. I thought, he's never gonna come off, never. I didn't know what else to do, but eventually I caught you. But he's got a very strong grip, very enjoyable. Thank you.
That's it for Ellery and for Lightning. Friends for life.
Lightning thanking Ellery. I think if I was Ellery, I'd be thanking Lightning. But if they're gonna be friends for life, let's hope they celebrate with a James Bond Christmas martini. Shaken but not stirred.
So our last two celebrity contenders are Derek, who's going to be chased by Zodiac, and Mark, who's going to be chased by Jet. Over to John Anderson.
Celebrities, you will go on my first whistle. Gladiators, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
So Jet will be coming after Mark, and Zodiac is on Derek. But if Derek is as fast up this wall as he was on the pyramid, then he's going to be up the top before Zodiac gets going. And here she comes. Oh, and Derek slipped a bit there. And Jet's already on Mark.
It looks like what Jet wants to do is beat Mark to the top. She's got him right now. Meanwhile, Derek on the right is up and over. Zodiac with no chance. Derek Redmond.
10 points. Second time this evening he's picked up maximum.
Jet has got
not again.
The soccer star, football star, all wrapped up and down he
when
goes.
When it is Christmas, Mike.
I think he may have wanted to get caught.
I'm sure he did.
I think looking at everybody else, you'd have preferred to be caught, wouldn't you?
Oh, I don't know about that. I'm just pleased to be up here and get 10 points. I'm quite pleased with that.
What's the hardest part of the wall?
The hardest part was coming over the end. I just clipped a certain part of my anatomy, which I could have done without clipping, actually.
Well done, you got yourself 10 points.
He should have been wearing his Christmas box. He climbs into the lead on 23, Eddie's on 20, Martin 19, Mark 17, Barry 11. Ellery sinks to the bottom on 9. Well, he shouldn't have enjoyed himself so much with Lightning.
Event number 4 is Pursuit, and we're kicking off with our two highest scorers. Eddie's going to be chased by Jet. And Derek's going to be chased by Lightning. Over to John Anderson.
Celebrities, you will go on my first whistle. Gladiators, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
And for this celebrity special, our celebs will get 5-second head starts.
It seems a lot, but I'm not sure it's going to be enough, Mike. Both Jet and Lightning extremely fast on this course. The contenders have only practiced this morning, whereas the girls should know it by now.
Can they catch these two fabulous athletes? Right now, Derek Redmond running away with it. He's already across the wire bridge, now on the hand ladder.
Uh-oh. Look out, Eddie. Jet's closing in on you. Oh, he's dropped off. What is he doing? He's chasing Jet now, and who can blame him? Derek Redmond's over the low wall into the web trap. Oh, interesting technique. Jet will tag Eddie. No points for him. Derek over the high wall with a tape in sight. Not unfamiliar to him.
Down the sprint finish goes Derek Redmond. He's got himself another 10 points.
He really is doing well tonight, Mike. And what a great technique on the web trap. He long jumps it.
So next up is Martin, who's going to be chased by Nightshade. And Mark's going to be pursued by Zodiac. Over to John Anderson.
Celebrities, you will go on my first whistle. Gladiators, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
Who has the better footwork? Our rugby star, or our goalkeeper?
Well, I think it's Mark. He's skipping on and off that beam. Like most goalkeepers, he doesn't like corners. Oh, he slipped over there and cut another corner. Martin doing well on the wire bridge. Here comes Mark.
Martin having all kinds of problems on the hand ladder.
I think the referee is turning a blind eye in this charity event. He's not even touched the end run. Merry Christmas, Martin.
Gladiators trying their darnest to catch up here.
Well, they're not going to catch Martin, probably the fastest winger in rugby today. The Gladiators not even in sight.
Martin is coasting home down the... well, we call it a sprint finish. He is just walking through this thing.
He's even got time to do his shoelaces up. I don't know what's happening here. Zodiac was chasing Mark, and it's Nightshade that's caught him. Well, what a confusion in this event. We had Martin missing rungs out on that ladder, and the Gladiators swapping celebrities. I'll blame it on the Christmas spirit.
Well, three very confused people here, myself, Mark, and Nightshade. Wasn't Zodiac chasing you, Mark?
Yeah, she was, actually.
This obviously wasn't pre-planned, Nightshade. All of a sudden, you're on him. What happened?
I just turned around. I thought, where's Martin gone? Oh, Zodiac seems to be after him, so I'll leave her to it. And then I got this charming young man, and that was fine by me. I shall go and watch a few games now.
I think you should. Nice work. Nightshade. And Mark.
Well, goalkeeper's not used to scoring, but it looks like Mark has.
So last up for pursuit, it's Barry, who's going to be chased by Falcon. And Ellery's going to be chased by Panther. Over to John Anderson.
Celebrities, you will go on my first whistle. Gladiators, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
Barry and Ellery, our last pair of celebrities to go here in pursuit. Given the 5-second head start, here comes Panther and Falcon.
And Mike, I have to tell you that this is the first time that Panther has rejoined Gladiators since a nasty fall on Chilt, and it's good to see her back. Well, what's happening here? Our two celebrities not too sure which wire bridge to take. They've sorted it out now, doing well, and they're neck and neck.
Now both men across. Barry on the hand ladder. So is Ellery. Whoop.
That's blown it.
Barry falls off momentarily. Look out, look out.
He's had it.
Falcon closing in. She's got her man.
Just like the Mounties.
No points for Barry McGuigan.
Let's see if Ellery can get into the points. That's if he ever gets out of that web trap. Wide-eyed and legless. Safely over the small wall. And onto the second web trap. But no sign of Panther.
Panther at the moment, no threat to catch the rugby star. Is he going to get a nice hand going down the sprint finish?
I'm sure he will, Mike. Oh, Panther taking a shortcut there, but it won't count. Ellery picking up 10 points, and he needed them. Oh, he picks up a cuddle from Panther, but he's glad he came on Gladiators. Cuddles from Lightning and Panther,
Ellery.
All in one show.
That wasn't bad, was it?
Oh, it wasn't bad. I'm getting used to this now, though. I like it.
Oh, I don't know if that's good or not. You did very, very well. 10 points.
Well, it helped from the first event. I got none, so I'm just hanging on in there. So I'm looking forward to the next event.
Let's hear it for Ellery. Excuse me, there was a touch of Lady Penelope going through those nets.
Yeah, it's good to be back, actually, Ulrika. I'm recovering from the bad back injury, and it's just nice to be able to be back on the course.
And to be just walking through it very casually, trying to cheat there in the end.
No, cheat? Not me. Actually, at this point, I'd like to say thank you to everybody who sent the get well messages and the flowers.
Aww.
Thanks very much, fans.
Let's hear it for Panther and Ellery. Well done.
Well done indeed. So after four events, Derek 33, Martin 29, Eddie 20, Ellery 19, Mark 17, Barry 11. Sadly, at this point, we say goodbye to our two lowest scoring celebrities, Mark and Barry.
Well, we have to lose two people, and it's a shame it's you two guys. I mean, have you had a good time?
Yeah, very much so. I really enjoyed the day, and hopefully be back sometime.
Yes, that would be great if you could come back, and I bet you're pleased to go home, aren't you?
A little bit, no. I really enjoyed myself and had a great time.
Well, you stay and watch. We've got another couple of events. Barry, you've not been feeling your best all night, have you?
No, I've been feeling a bit lousy. My knee was hurting this morning in practice, but I don't want to use that as an excuse. I've had a tremendous time. My wife and kids have had a great time. I was looking forward to the duel with Wolf to get my own back. He pulled my trousers down at the start.
A man can take, quite frankly.
Absolutely. I was looking forward to getting him back. But we've had a great time. And, you know, hey, it's for a good, great cause. It's for charity.
Absolutely. It's been nice to see you here on Gladiators. You out of the goal and you out of the commentating box. And I expect we'll be hearing a lot from you later on. So we still have two events left to go, Duel and the Eliminator. Join us after the break here on Gladiators.
So, welcome back to part three, event five, the Duel. And the first up is Ellery. He's going to be facing the unmistakable Hunter! Over to John Anderson.
Although the celebrities are having fun this evening, we asked Ellery, were they taking the challenge seriously?
Everybody wants to win who comes here. They have a secret desire. Everybody's thinking to themselves, yeah, I don't want to embarrass myself. I want to do as well as I can. But deep down, really, there's a competitive edge in everybody because most people obviously will come. They've either played sport at some level and they feel that they either want to win or, as I said, do well or beat the person who they're competing with. And I feel I want to do that too as well. I know it's a tough schedule, but I'm looking forward to it.
Three!
Usually the man who responds to the whistle first, the victor in the duel.
That's right.
Hunter on the attack right away. Ellery just trying to defend himself and now in trouble.
Giving away free stone here, Mike.
Hunter wailing away. Ellery, a big, strong man himself. Not quite the size of Hunter, but he's got a low center of gravity. He's not budging up there on that dual platform.
Good shot. Hunter has a 4-inch height advantage.
Hunter with two huge shots. Still Ellery not going anywhere.
Oh, good jab.
And that is it.
It's a draw.
Ellery Hanley will get 5 points for going the distance with Hunter. He gets the draw.
The hard way, and if we check out the replay, Hunter throws some tremendous combinations together. Ellery takes a licking but keeps on sticking. Next up on the podium is Eddie Kidd. Eddie, 5'11" and 12 stone 7 pounds.
Just been to the toilet.
Well, that's a relief, because tonight he faces Shadow. This courageous stuntman has faced many dangers in his career. Here he is, jumping the Great Wall of China. Well, tonight, another great danger to face, Shadow, of course, and I bet he wishes he had his motorbike with him so he can make a fast exit.
Celebrity ready! Gladiator ready! On top!
As a stuntman, Eddie has been in peril's path before, but nothing quite like this. Shadow lives for this event.
Oh, Eddie, a little previous there.
Eddie, whistle hasn't even blown yet, guys.
Shadow, wait for the whistle.
I think we all know it's Eddie's fault. I've not seen anyone try that on Shadow before. What do you think, Mike?
Not a good idea to get the awesome Shadow upset or irritated.
Indeed not.
Two, one.
Well, 5 stone and 4 inch advantage to Shadow, and isn't he making it pay? Look at those shots, Mike.
1, 2, 3, 4 shots on the back of Eddie Kidd's head. Shadow gets the job done.
He certainly does in style. Check out the replay. Look at this. Eddie never had a chance. He may have jumped the Great Wall of China, but tonight he jumped from the dual platform.
Well done, Eddie. You're still alive, are you?
Just about. That guy hits hard, I'm telling you.
Your wife's in the audience. What do you think she'd be thinking right now?
That she could hit me as hard as him.
Shadow?
It's been great competing with these guys. Anyone who would come out and compete against the Gladiators, who shows a lot of courage, demands respect.
Yeah, let's hear it for Eddie and Shadow! Next up is Martin Offiah. And he's going to be against Trojan! Over to John Anderson.
On guard!
Well, Martin, a rugby league player, only giving away 1 inch in height, but just under 4 stone in weight.
3, 2, 1!
Here we go, Trojan against Martin. And
oh,
Martin,
he's bullying him!
In a hurry, and he doesn't want any part of the big man, Trojan.
Well, he said earlier he runs away from the big man. He certainly ran away from Trojan.
Whipping the rugby star in about 3-4 seconds.
Oh, Martin. Took some licks there. You didn't want to hang about there, did you?
No, it was a lot easier when we were practicing.
They hit hard, don't they?
Oh, yeah. Just once you lose your balance, you know, you've gone.
Was it possible to fight back? It didn't look like you wanted to fight back.
Well, I just couldn't. You can't throw any blows. I tried to keep my weight on the front foot, but once I took a hit, you know, I put the guard up, but still I was off balance.
Well, this guy is tough. Strong. You can imagine what it'd be like fighting against Shadow, can't you?
Oh, God, yeah.
Trojan, couple of excellent blows there.
I was getting to the hang of it now. It's like Christmas time, but I wasn't giving out no presents today.
Were you disappointed he jumped off so early?
I thought you're going to stay there a bit longer, you know?
Want to take some more punishment?
Yeah, I thought we were going to go up there, have a cappuccino between us and have a nice time, but it was good. You did it right.
Well done, Trojan and Martin.
Well, I don't know if he takes sugar in his cappuccino, but Trojan certainly served up a couple of lumps there.
And next up is our 400-metre sprinter, Derek Redmond. And he's going to be up against a Saracen.
Well, sprinting not an asset in this event.
Oh, what a John Anderson.
In the words of Martha Reeves and the Vandellas, there's nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. And he's giving away 5.5 stone and 3 inches in height. Derek, desperately unlucky in the Olympic Games when he pulled that hamstring and had to be assisted over the line by his father.
And indeed, John, Derek has treated all of these events here in our celebrity special like it was the 400-meter final of the Olympics.
Yes, you're right, Mike.
Very serious about winning it all. Derek Redmond against Saracen. Here we go.
Let's get ready to rumble.
Derek now down to one knee, now back up.
Some good licks.
Saracen getting real aggressive, perhaps irritated that Derek is able to hit him with all these shots.
He looks worried. Oh, it's caught over. He's caught over.
Saracen disqualifies himself for being overly aggressive. Crossing over to Derek's platform. That will give this sprinter 10 points.
Well done, Derek.
And a huge lead going into the eliminator.
David and Goliath. Anyone got a tin opener for that helmet?
Well done, Derek. You've seen it all before. It's different. Different the other side, isn't it?
When you're standing down there, you see one contender, one gladiator. When you're up there, you're the one contender, you get one hit, you see three gladiators. So I just thought I'd let the one in the middle.
But Derek, you were going for his leg, a couple of blows to the stomach, a couple of the head. Looked like you rehearsed that, you practiced it.
Well, I'd seen quite a few people do it, so I thought, bob and weave, see what you can do. But wherever Bob came, his pugil stick came, so.
Well, that was a great fight. That was hell for leather, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah, well, if you're gonna go out, you might as well go out fighting.
Well done, you got yourself 10 points! Yeah. Saracen, hey, this guy, he surprised a few, eh? Surprised them.
He was very tough. He wasn't gonna put me off. So I thought, I'll go blow for blow. Every time he hit me, I hit him. He was weaving, he was going, and I stepped across.
Unlucky. Let's hear it for Saracen. 10 points, Derek Redmond!
After 5 events, Derek is top of the tree on 43, Martin O'Fire 29, Ellery Hanley 24, Eddie Kidd 20. Again, we lose the 2 lowest scorers, so our 2Es, Ellery and Eddie, get the biggie.
Well, Ellery, unfortunately, we've got to say bye-bye to you, but most importantly, have you enjoyed it?
It's been absolutely tremendous, and I'd like to say thank you to all the crowd. They've been absolutely marvellous, and I think that it'd be great if we can have more events like this for charity, because I think it's a fantastic cause and a worthy cause for everybody, and it's a great entertainment for children and everybody, adults and everybody. Thank you very much.
Ellery Hanley, thanks very much. And Eddie, unfortunately, you've got to go as well. But Eddie, I've got to say to you, I mean, you're a man, you put your life in your own hands many, many times. I mean, it must have been frightening up there with Shadow.
Well, he's big, you know, and I thought I heard the whistle, so anyway, I got in there early, but Shadow didn't like it, he put me down quite quick.
This was the early blows
that,
you got in.
That was the early tactic, it didn't work though.
Damn good idea. See you later. You enjoyed it?
Yeah, brilliant, and I'd love to do it again, it's been brilliant.
Well, I'm sure we'll have you both on again. Thanks very much, see you later. Eddie and Ellery. Excellent.
Who will be our celebrity champion? The Eliminator will tell the tale. It's track and field great versus rugby star. At the moment, Derek has a 14-point lead on Martin, which means the 400-meter ace will get a 7-second head start.
Remember, he's against one of the fastest rugby league wingers in the world.
Derek, you will go on my first whistle. Martin, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
track and field speed versus rugby speed. They are slightly different. However, Martin does have the potential to make this race close.
He certainly does, Mike, but you've got to remember Derek Redmond has been totally focused throughout the entire competition.
And look at him go on that hand ladder.
Tremendous speed.
Now across the rolling beam.
Onto the cargo
net. You know, he has a secret desire to one day become a gladiator himself.
Don't we all?
He'd have to put on a little bulk, but there's no question he would fare well in these events.
Martin safely across the rolling beam and onto the cargo net.
Martin closing in.
But Derek is across to the zip line. Who bet against him now?
The only break our contenders get throughout this eliminator.
Good landing. And Martin having a torrid time on that cargo net.
Steady as she goes. Derek across the balance beam, now the travelator.
And he punishes the final obstacle. So Derek Redmond, the 400-meter track star, is now Gladiator Celebrity Champion 1994. Well, I've never seen it done like that before. Oh, he slips. Hope he hasn't hurt his ankle as he pumps up the travelator. Oh, he dives for it. Fingertips.
Crowd here at the NIA not letting Martin quit.
They never do, Mike.
He finishes.
Only just.
Congratulations, Derek. There's your lovely, magnificent Celebrity Gladiator Trophy and a cheque for £5,000 to charity of your choice, which is, I'm actually going to split the money. It's going to the Sports Aid Foundation, who's helped myself and my wife Sharon plenty of times in the past, and also to Northampton General Hospital, to the children's section, because they helped us quite a lot when Elliot was born.
Well done. I've got to ask you, have you enjoyed today?
I've really enjoyed today. I'm glad I've won, but Fash, I would have liked you in there. You were last year's champion. Next year, mate, let's get it on.
Next year will be a very interesting year. I look forward to that challenge.
Okay, so do I.
Let's hear it for Derek Redmond!
Martin, it has to be said, no one ever on Gladiators has attacked the eliminator course in the way that you did. I mean, you were trying to get up that net, going hell for leather, had a little bit of trouble on the beam, and nearly slipped off at the end, and up that travelator. I mean, you've seen it on the telly, what's it like?
Oh, it's a lot easier, isn't it?
Watching?
Oh, very much so.
Well, you must be pleased with second place.
Well, yeah. Obviously, I didn't think I'd get very far, but, you know, I'm quite pleased, obviously. You know, Derek, I think it's not fair, really. I think he should be a gladiator, not a challenger.
Don't give him any ideas. You know what he's like. Now, you've got this trophy, and in here, I have a cheque for £2,000. You better get thinking about some charities, haven't you?
Yeah, I did. Ellery wanted me to go to his charity. Well, I don't think I can do that, but as I say, not, you know, expecting to win, I'll have to think about a worthwhile charity, but I'm sure.
But basically, some charities for the care of children.
Very much so.
Well, it's been great having you on the show. I hope you come back sometime. Martin Offiah! We sincerely hope you've enjoyed this celebrity special version of Gladiators. We certainly have. You've enjoyed it?
Oh, yes, very good.
But we're going to see you soon. Bye-bye.
Ooga!
For safety reasons, do not attempt to recreate any of the events you have seen on Gladiators.
One of telly's most popular quiz show hosts, Jim Bowen, returns with crisp 10s and 20s and maybe even a caravan. Bullseye is next on Challenge. And tonight at 9, Bradley Walsh tries to keep a straight face in the chase.